most important incident of Indian music is the appearance of the Gandharvas. Now, who are Gandharvas? If we go through our Vedas and Vedic literature, we can find there are so many human races like Gandharva, Kindara, Gana, Veti, and so on. Each race has their own culture. The Gandharvas, it is assumed that their homelands were Kandahar, that is now in Pakistan. And the three types of Gandharvas can be traced. One is Divya Gandharva. Div means light. The people, the Gandharvas who were enlightened or learned, known as Divya Gandharva. And other Gandharvas was known as Kali Gandharva and general Gandharvas. But we are concerned with the Divya Gandharva. Divya Gandharvas were mentioned as Ketopu. Ketopu means the men who are concerned with the mathematics and science. As we can rather imagine that this type of Gandharva, that is Divya Gandharva, were responsible for the development of Indian music, that is the science of Indian music. They discovered seven notes of Indian notes and ascribed them to Sarigama Padanisha. Sarja, Rishabh, Gandhara, Madhyama, Panchama, Taibhava, Nisarga. And they used string instruments, maybe called as Veena. And naturally, when they used Veena in their music, the notes were ascending. And in Bharata Natashastra, the Gandharva's music is mentioned in this way. Swara Padu Taratmakam. That means all the intricacies of Swara, Padu and Tal. The intricacies of Swaras means Subdha Swara, Vikrita Swara, Murchana, skill or grammar. Padu. Padu means lyrical compositions. The lyrical compositions of Samagana are known richer. And in Gandharva, there are two types of lyric. One is known as Vastu and the other was known as Akshiddhika. The tune of Gandharva music were also two types. That is Jati and Raga. That is modal songs and melodic songs. Modal songs based on rhythmic patterns. Melodic songs were graceful notes, used graceful notes. Naturally, graceful notes were later known as raga and the jati, the modal notes. The seven notes and we intermixing seven jatis and 18 modal structures. That is 18 jatis. The Gandharva ragas mainly based on two musical scales known as Sarjakram and Madhyamakram. Again, the regional gestures were also indulged. They accepted the regional style of singing in Gandharva ragas also, known as Githi. Shuddha Giti, Pinna Giti, Gauri Giti, Shadrani Giti, Vesara Giti, etc. Gandharva melodies or ragas are Kram Raga, Vasha Raga, Raga, Uparaga. Uparaga means it's not actually bears all the characteristics of a raga. Kram Raga is nothing but a structure of tune, rigid. On the basis of those tunes, one can compose songs. Asharagas, like Gramragas, but there is a scope of using additional notes, and also it should have an alap. Without alap, a composition based on vasadeva cannot be performed. That was the rule of those days. Then raga. Raga means like gram raga, but the singing style, wherever the ragas will be used, the singing style of those areas will be followed. And lastly, uparagas. I told you, uparagas are nothing but semi-ragas, I should say, semi-ragas, not perfect ragas. These melodies, whether jatis or ragas, were used in the compositions of Gandharva song. There are two types. One type is known as dhruva. Dhruva means dramatic songs, and the other is known as parigitika. Parigitika means simple compositions, vocal compositions. Besides the Gandharva Gita, also there were deshi or regional music. Deshi does not indicate the folk. Here, deshi means urban music. That is the music which were used in towns, cities, etc. And the melodies were known as deshi ragas. But in deshi, jatis were not mentioned. So only ragas, deshi ragas. And these deshi ragas particularly are not in the same pattern. The ragas are having the same name. The ragas of Bengal differs from the ragas of Isha, having the same name. Doesn't matter. But the regional performance styles were highly appreciable in those ragas. The compositions of Deshi were known as Prakirno or Padogano. There are two types of padas. One is Kavya Pado, that is not musical. Musical was known as Gyo Pado, which requires melodies. But Kavya Pado requires recitation. Gyo Pado should have lyrical part or dhatu. But in poetic Pado, that is Kavya Pado, simply for used for recitation, they should not have any dhatu. Prakirno means the urban songs which are immensely found in different parts of India, from Kashmir to Kanyakumari, from Assam to Gujarat. Later times, these Prakirno included some of the rigid musical laws. They became Viprakirno, Vishesh Prakirno, Viprakirno. Our Kirtan, Bengali Kirtan, Assamese Kirtan, the Kirtanam of South India are Prakirno type, also Padogana. And later time it became more rigid, known as Prabandha. Prabandha, which followed the rules of swaro, rules of pado, rules of tala, very rigidly, was Prabandha. But if you indulge any ingredient of these three things, will be known as rupaka, Prabandha rupaka. Rupaka means you are giving rupa, your new imagination. And Prabandha, when it becomes slightly slackened, known as salaga sura. Prabandha has part two types, sura and alikrama. Sura means the pure Prabandha, and when it is distorted slightly, known as salaga sura. And what is alikrama? Alikrama means the rules of Prabandha is rigidly followed. But one of the things, either rag or the language, the lyric, what was mentioned in Gujarati language, but somebody has taken it to UP language, then it will be salaga sura. But other rules are exactly the same thing. Like the Bengali khyal or Bengali dhrupad, that is salaga sura. If you don't understand this, you cannot realize the evolution of Indian music.